Hello and welcome to another session on interpreting linear equations. These are now hard questions. Let's see. The temperature in degrees Celsius of a certain city is modeled by the linear function TT. Represents the time in hours after midnight. Okay, again, it's the same side of sort of question. The temperature is recorded every hour for a 24-hour period. Which of the following options is correct? Okay. So for a 24-hour period. So when 12 hours is passed, noon, it says 15 degrees. Let's check if it has. So that gives me plus 30. No, that should be 24. So the first answer option is wrong. Let's see if the next answer option is correct. 0.5 times 6 plus 30. That gives me 28. Okay. And then minus 0.5 times 15, 3 p.m. should be 24.5. Oh, okay, 0.5 times 6 is 3, minus 3 plus 30, that's 27, not 28. Okay, minus 7.5 plus 30, that should be 22.5. Okay, what about 9 p.m.? 9 p.m. is how many hours? 12 plus 9 hours. 12 plus 9 is 21. 21 times minus 0.5 and plus 30. I think that should be the right answer. The next one says the equation 3x minus 4y equals to 8 represents a linear function in standard form. Which of the following statements is true about this function? So 3x equals to 8 plus, let's try to make y the subject, because I'm asking you questions about the slope and the y-intercept or the x-intercept. Let's see if it fits. The first thing that I know is the slope has to be 3 over 4 and the y-intercept is minus 2. Yes, that sort of fits. That should be the right answer. The temperature in a city during a winter day is modeled by the linear equation this, where TT represents this. What will be the temperature be? What time will the temperature be 10 degrees Fahrenheit? Okay, so when will it be 10 degrees Fahrenheit? So 10 equals to minus 3t plus 50. Now I'm assuming that the counting starts from 00. It means it starts at the night at 12 a.m. Okay, so 10 minus 50. It's midnight. Okay, so minus 3t minus 50 divided by minus 3. Okay, then I need this to change into hours and minutes. I think I have that here. No, that's not here. On minus 50, it's minus 40 divided by minus 3. So minus 40 divided by minus 3. So that's 13.33. 13 means it's 1 p.m. So it should be 1:19 p.m. There is a button on the calculator that sort of changes this. Yes, I found it. So it's shift and plus. Okay. So that gives you 13 hours and 20 minutes. It's about 1:20, but the answer option has 1:19, so I'm going to go with that. Okay. A car rental company charges a fixed fee of $30 per day, an additional fee of 0.10 miles per driven. The cost in dollars for renting a car for 10 days and driving m miles is given by the function this. Okay. Which of the following statements is true about the given function? The function is a linear function of d and m. Yes, d and m both have powers 1. The function is a quadratic. No, the function is an exponential. No. I think it should be a linear function. Let's check our hints. All the powers are 1. Yeah. None of them are being multiplied. So yes, it should be a linear function. Okay. That. Okay, consider the function this f of a is a straight line. What is the value of f of 0? So I can construct this expression. I can say that when x is minus 2, y is 8, and when x is 3, y is 2. So gradient is 2 minus 8 over 3 minus minus 2 minus 6 over 5. That's the gradient. Let's check for the y-intercept. X. Okay, I can take any point that I want and write down. So 28 over 5 is C, that's what I'm getting, I think. 2 plus 6 into 3 over 5. 28 over 5, so y equals to minus 6 over 5x plus 28 over 5. When I plug in x equals to 0, I get 28 over 5. Let's see the next set of hard questions. It says a car rental company charges a flat fee of $5 per day plus an additional $0.20 per mile driven. The function CM represents the total cost. So $5 per day plus 0.20 m. It says if the total cost to rent a car for 150 miles is $70, what does the car rental company charge for the flat fee? Okay, it's a flat fee, it's not per day. I'm assuming that there's only one day involved, I'm not going into multiple days. So 150f plus 0.20, sorry, this is 70, that's the cost, that's 150. So what's 70 minus 0.2 times 150? 40. It's $40 per day. That's the flat fee. The revenue in dollars from the sales of X units is given by this, where X is the number of units sold. The cost in dollars to produce X units of the product is given by the function CX equals to this. Find the break-even point. Okay, break-even point is when revenue equal cost. It's a really weird revenue function with minus 2. I don't understand what's going on there, but I'm just going to calculate whatever the answer is coming up. X equals to 60. Okay, a company produces and sells widgets at a constant rate. The linear function WT represents the number of widgets the company T produces. The company produces 300 widgets in the first 2 hours and 700 widgets in the first 6 hours. What is the rate at which widgets are being produced? So 300 divided by 2, 700 divided by 6, that sort of looks odd. So if I have a linear function, it should be mx plus c. Okay, so I'm going to say that 300 widgets in the first 2 hours. Okay, I could also calculate the slope. Okay, it's just asking me for the slope. So let's just do that. Okay, 700 minus 300 over 6 minus 2. Y2 minus Y1 over X2 minus X1. So that's 400 over 4. That's about 100 widgets per hour. Okay, line 2 is denoted by FKL intersects line L at the point Q, which is the following. So whenever you have intersection points, you solve simultaneously. So x equals to 1 and y equals to minus 1. Given the equation of a line y equals to 3x plus 4 and has an x coordinate of 2, specifically the point x we are interested in is 2 comma y. Using this information, solve the value for y. Okay, so 3 times 2 plus 4, that's simple, 10. Okay, that brings us to the end of this topic. I will see you with the next topic in the next video. Thank you for watching.